Kingdom of God Life STYLE Monarchies and Misunderstandings. You acknowledge the modern opposition to monarchies, highlighting the importance of distinguishing between the concept of a kingdom and the potential errors of its earthly ruler. This distinction aligns with the Kingdom of God, where our benevolent King takes responsibility for the well-being of his citizens. Evil kingdoms and earthly challenges, your recognition of the fallen nature of this world and the presence of evil kingdoms resonates with the challenges we face. The contrast between corrupt democracies and the Kingdom of God underscores the need to discern the source of values and character in any government or kingdom. Embracing kingdom values, referencing Matthew 6:25-33, you beautifully capture the essence of trusting in God's provision and focusing on the kingdom. This passage emphasizes the benevolence of our King, encouraging a shift from a worry-filled mindset to one centered on seeking the kingdom of God. Therefore I tell you, do not worry about your life, what you will eat or drink, or about your body, what you will wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes? Matthew 6:25, NIV. The kingdom concept in Jesus' ministry, you emphasize that the core of Jesus' ministry was centered on the kingdom concept. His teachings and parables consistently underscore the importance of understanding and embracing the kingdom of God. This aligns with the message of John the Baptist, who proclaimed the nearness of the kingdom of heaven. From that time Jesus began to preach and to say, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand." Matthew 4:17, NKJV. Kingdom in action, your instruction to prioritize speaking about the kingdom of God while demonstrating it through actions is a powerful reminder. This aligns with Jesus' instructions to his disciples. Follow Lady Janice, subscribe, comments important. Shalom.